Hi, Dr. Ramsey Choucair, board certified plastic surgeon in Dallas, Texas, coming to you with another video to educate our patients about aesthetic plastic surgery. Today we're going to talk about removing buccal fat, which currently has become a very trendy thing, and even though it's been around for years, you know how social media can turn something that's been around for years into something that seems new. So removing buccal fat has been available, and it usually is fat that is congenital fat in general, and it usually is above the jawline. It's not where the jowl fat is. It's not the jawline fat. It's the fat usually just above it, but it can be confusing to patients and some doctors whether that fat is jowl fat, which can be removed with liposuction, or whether it's buccal fat, which is a little bit higher. Some patients who have genetically significant or excess buccal fat can give their face a full look and not give them a contour in this area above the jawline. And those are the patients specifically, genetically, who have too much buccal fat that we tend to treat. The procedure is straightforward. It's 99%, in my experience, done through the mouth, inside the mouth, to tease out the fat. It takes usually 45 minutes to an hour, depending. It's under a light general anesthetic. It can be very effective in someone who has too much fat in the buccal area. It is not something that treats the jowl fat. And that's the real distinction, and that's why you have to find a board-certified plastic surgeon who knows those nuances. The downside of taking buccal fat in someone young who doesn't need it is a concavity or an indentation that makes them look less than normal. So it shouldn't be done unless it's necessary. Hope that helps. Wow.